young and beautiful for him. A power that won't ever will be. But he marvelous to do the hornet. Is an upgraded version for previous model, the RP600. This is the first argument for the turn test. It will be the perfect personal assistance. It will take care of your everyday tasks, so you have more time to enjoy life.
Remember,
animals can be our perfect partners. This is clearly a render inspired by the game Detroit Become Human, an amazing game that, if you have played, you probably have asked yourself, is it even possible to build an android like Chloe? Let's find out.
Fire!
For an android like Chloe to be able to pass the Turing test, it first needs to generate text to follow a conversation, and for that, we have GPT-3, an AI that can generate human-like text. This AI is capable of performing many tasks, like generating code, writing novels, creating websites, and much more. It is also capable of natural language processing and understanding the context of a sentence, but it is not perfect and has some limitations, of course. It's not able to understand the context of a sentence if the sentence is too long or if the grammar is incorrect. It also struggles with understanding idioms and sarcasm. That can be a problem considering that speech to text AI is not always perfect, but it's good enough that maybe you don't realize that part of this section was written by GPT-3.
And this would be over here if we just try to recreate
a virtual
assistant like Monica.
Chloe needs
to be able to speak with humans.
For that,
Google published a paper 3 years ago where they were able to clone a voice
in a sample
over 5 seconds to achieve this. This AI uses text as an input
to generate
a spectrogram that represents the voice and intonation to be used during this process. And later, this can be computed into a wave format that we can listen. Here we still need a human to do this sample for the first time.
But this
explains why CyberKnight did a research to find the most pleasant voice codes. Because this
they can hard
for these people to be their voice
or their androids.
Now it's up to you to decide
if this technique
is good enough for the real one.
CyberKnight will 3D print their android, so 3D model must succeed. To get a big variety of ethnicities, it's not easy that we use an AI. Anyone developed by Microsoft to try other AIs. Here, the process begins with a temple face, and then it randomizes the identity, expression, texture, hair, and clothes to get a big variety of androids. And, or better say, data humans. And we know that the NVIDIA is capable to use the audio generated previously to animate the face with a given expression. But what about the rest of the body? Well, Ubisoft Unbelievable has been able to develop an AI capable of predicting the future from a single pose and works in real time just like a video, and also works in not humanoid forms. But this is not all, because in a virtual world we can use this universe to train the robots to learn how to be digital assistants, like DeepMind did in the research. Another advantage of training the AIs in a virtual world is that this world can change, and this makes the AIs learn the concepts, learn their limitations, but also it allows them to adapt to new situations. If you have paid attention so far, we have it only in a virtual world, but OpenAI and Tesla have proved that it's possible to transfer this virtual knowledge to the real world. Tesla uses this technique all the time to train in weird situations like this one. In this case, the data comes from images, and these images can be labeled to later get a specific information and make these cards take decisions. And if you ask me, this is probably what Quantic Dream tried to recreate with this effect. We also know that in 2019, OpenAI made a robotic arm capable of manipulating a cube. So it's not crazy to believe that if a company dedicates time for the whole body locomotion, they can make an android. And this is the reason why maybe Elon Musk announced to be doing this. The problem here is that CyberLife wanted these androids to be a human copy, and for today's standards, this can enter easy the uncanny valley. But maybe if the mechanical parts recreate the muscle system of a human face, this can be solved. And once this is solved, the only problem left to solve is to find an equivalent to the Ethereum 3.1.0. This is the battery of these androids. And for me, it's the more impossible to exist. Well, in the real life, kinda exists this type of technology. A liquid metal battery will explode when an android moves. So if you think about it, maybe Kamski really wanted to have these androids being the perfect human, because these parts are not usable, and maybe Kamski really wanted these androids to be the perfect partner. If you ask me, in no time we'll have a personal digital assistant in our phones, but it will take a couple of years to find out if we can really have a relationship with an android. A good time to think if we really need to have humanoid robots in our lives, because if they can exist, will they take our jobs? Will they replace our love? How far can we humans push the morals to play a god? Will we follow the same destiny as the great gods, just to be destroyed by your own creation? Only time will tell.